Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Friday of the 34th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. The Lord speaks of peace to His people and His holy ones, and to those who turn to Him.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Stir up the will of your faithful, we pray, O Lord, that striving more eagerly to bring your divine work to fruitful completion, they may receive in greater measure the healing remedies your kindness bestows. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. In a vision, I, Daniel, saw during the night the four winds of heaven stirred up the great sea, from which emerged four immense beasts, each different from the others. The first was like a lion, but with eagle's wings. While I watched, the wings were plucked. It was raised from the ground to stand on 2 feet like a man, and given a human mind. The second was like a bear. It was raised up on one side, and among the teeth in its mouth were 3 tusks. It was given the order, up, devour much flesh. After this, I looked and saw another beast, like a leopard. On its back were 4 wings like those of a bird, and it had 4 heads. To this beast dominion was given. After this, in the visions of the night, I saw the 4 beasts, different from all the others, terrifying, horrible, and of extraordinary strength. It had great iron teeth, with which it devoured and crushed, and what was left it trampled with its feet. I was considering the 10 horns it had, when suddenly another, a little horn, sprang out of their midst, and 3 of the previous horns were torn away to make room for it. This horn had eyes like a man, and a mouth that spoke arrogantly. As I watched, thrones were set up, and the Ancient One took his throne. His clothing was snow bright, and the hair on his head as white as wool. His throne was flames of fire, with wheels of burning fire. A surging stream of fire flowed out from where he sat. Thousands upon thousands were ministering to him, and myriads upon myriads attended him. The court was convened, and the books were opened. I watched, then, from the first of the arrogant words which the horn spoke, until the beast was slain and its body thrown into the fire to be burnt up. The other beasts, which also lost their dominion, were granted a prolongation of life for a time and a season. As the visions during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the Ancient One and was presented before him, he received dominion, glory, and kingship. Nations and peoples of every language serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Give glory and eternal praise to him.
Give glory and eternal praise to him.
Mountains and hills, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever.
Give glory and eternal praise to him.
Everything growing from the earth, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt Him forever.
Give glory and eternal praise to Him.
You springs, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt Him above all forever.
Give glory and eternal praise to Him.
Seas and rivers, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt Him above all forever.
Give glory and eternal praise to Him.
You dolphins and all water creatures, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt Him above all forever.
Give glory and eternal praise to Him.
All you birds of the air, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt Him above all forever.
Give glory and eternal praise to Him.
All you beasts, wild and tame, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt Him above all forever.
Give glory and eternal praise to Him.
Alleluia, alleluia. Stand erect and raise your heads because your redemption is at hand. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told His disciples a parable. Consider the fig tree and all other trees. When the buds burst open, you see for yourselves and know that summer is now near. In the same way, when you see these things happening, know that the kingdom of God is near. Amen, I say to you, until all these things have taken place, heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Ngayon, pinagpapatuloy natin yung mga pagbasa natin mula sa chapter 21 ni San Lucas. Kagaya ng sinabi natin, di ba, itong buong linggon to ay yung paghahanda natin sa second coming of Christ, ang muling pagbabalik ng Panginoon. Dapat natin matandaan, di ba, bahagi ito ng misteryo ng ating pananampalataya. Si Kristo'y namatay, si Kristo'y nabuhay, si Kristo'y babalik sa wakas ng panahon. And I think this part of the second coming of Christ as part of the mystery of our faith, really, again, just like the resurrection, no, is the game changer. Because ours now is we have a vision of the future and a vision of history which is tending towards Christ. No? And I think one of the most beautiful, you might say, frameworks for this is the book of Father Teilhard de Chardin. We took him up in philosophy 101, the philosophy of man, no? The phenomenon of man. In that book, Father Teilhard de Chardin says that everything, he also believed in the theory of evolution, no? He was part of the team, he was a scientist and also a philosopher. He was part of the team that discovered the Peking Man, for those who remember that, no? Which was a major discovery in evolution, the theory of evolution. So Father Teilhard believes that everything is tending towards the omega point. Everything is evolving towards the omega point, who is Christ, no? And that is really the meaning of the second coming of Christ, that our lives have meaning because our lives are evolving towards Christ, towards the perfection of Christ, the person of Christ, the second coming of Christ. Siguro yung unang puntong pagnilayan natin kasi yun ang napakamalalim na kahulugan ng ating mga ebanghelyo nitong linggong ito. At yun din yung ating pinaghahandaan sa darating na bagong liturgical year, no, ang Adbiento, no, na pinaghahandaan natin ang second coming of Christ. Maybe that first point to reflect on. No? Then the second point is that part of the message of the Gospels and today's Gospel is that we just don't wait for the second coming. And at the same time, we don't fret, hindi tayo yung praning, di ba, sa muling pagbabalik ng Panginoon. But I think basically the invitation also for us is to live our lives that we will become worthy of Christ. I think that is the important reminder for us of constantly recalling that there is a second coming of Christ, no? And remember, Christ is already present in our midst. The kingdom of God is already present in our midst. But the perfection of that kingdom and the perfection of Christ with us will come in the second coming. So, but we must make ourselves worthy for the second coming and to become members now of, of the community of Christ, of the kingdom of God, as we say, di ba, the proleptic presence, na narito na pero hindi pa sa kaganapan. Na dapat ay tayo'y maging karapat-dapat, di ba, sa ating pamumuhay sa araw-araw, maging karapat-dapat tayo sa pagdating ng Panginoon at magiging pahagi ng kaharian ng Diyos. Siguro yung pangalawang puntong yon, ano? Yung huli at pangatlong punto, sabi ng Panginoon, heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Here again, it is the certainty of Christ's message and mission. That remember, in Christ, the definitive revelation of God is done with the cross and resurrection. Na ang Panginoon ang siyang masasabi natin kabuuan at pagiging perpekto ng paghahayag ng Diyos sa atin. No? The revelation of God to us is perfect and complete in the cross and resurrection of Christ. And to complete this mystery is the second coming. And yet all of these now are one, really, are a united mystery already here, but tending towards perfection. So today, panalangin natin na tayo ay maging karapat-dapat, tayo ay maging handa, tayo ay maging, masasabi natin na namumuhay na ang ating pananaw, ang ating abot-tanaw, ang ating horizon ay ang kaharian ng Diyos. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord Jesus has called us to watch for the day of His return. Let us come to the Father in prayer, watching and waiting for His return. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may respond to the call for conversion and renewal, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people of goodwill may work together to put an end to war and hatred, oppression and injustice, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may increase our awareness of the presence of Christ among the poor and the suffering people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And together now, let us again remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And we also remember all the souls of the faithful departed, the souls in purgatory commended to our prayers during these Masses of November. For all of this, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And together, let us pray for our panalangin para sa halalan 2022. Diyos aming Ama, sa paghahanda namin para sa aming halalan 2022, nagtitiwala kami sa iyong pangako na magpapadala ka sa amin ng mga pinunong naaayon sa iyong puso at diwa. Panginoong Jesus, bigyang inspirasyon mo ang lahat ng naghahangad ng katungkulan upang maging mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na uunahin ang higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami. Lalong-lalo na ang mga mahihirap, mga nasa laylayan at mga mahina, higit sa anumang interes na pansarili o para sa grupo. Mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na maghahangad ng katungkulan upang tunay na maglingkod at hindi paglingkuran. Mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na may integridad at tunay na malasakit. Banal na Espiritu, tanglawan ang aming mga isip at puso nang aming makita ng malinaw ang mga tunay na pangangailangan ng aming mga kapwa Pilipino at kung ano ang pinapangako ng mga kandidato at ang kanilang kakayahang isakatuparan ng mga ito. Nang aming piliin ng tama mga pinuno na may natunay na mamumuno at maglilingkod, mga pinuno ayon sa iyong sariling puso at diwa, at mga pinuno na magbubuklod at mamumuno sa amin upang gawin naming lahat kung anong higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami at para sa iyong higit na kaluwalhatian. Ama, Anak at Espiritu, Ikaw ang Diyos ng buhay at pag-ibig, ang Panginoon ng kasaysayan. Naway makasama ka namin sa oras na ito ng aming paghahanda para sa darating na halalan. Amen. Birhen ng Fatima,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
Immaculada Concepcion, Patron ng Pilipinas,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
By the mystery of this water and wine, May we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the sacred offerings which, at your bidding, we dedicate to your name, and in order that through these gifts we may become worthy of your love, grant us unfailing obedience to your commands, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate his death. With living faith we proclaim his resurrection. With unwavering hope, we await his return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Remember also, most specially, all the souls of the faithful departed, the souls in purgatory, commended to our prayers during these Masses in November. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through Him, with Him, and in Him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us spend moments of silence. And together, let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic and ask for your healing love to overcome our fear of sickness and death and to strengthen our faith and hope. We pray for all health workers, protect and sustain them. For those who passed on, reward them with eternal life and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe and guide them, most especially our leaders. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying, and those who died in agony and loneliness. Be their consolation. Embrace them and their families with your love. We pray for families who suffer due to loss of jobs and income, and for all who experience anxiety and fear. May they know they are not alone. Inspire us all to come together in fraternal love for and service to one another. Guide our experts, instruments in your healing hands, to continue to develop effective vaccines and cures for this virus. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, and our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petitions and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. We pray, Almighty God, that those to whom you give the joy of participating in divine mysteries may never be parted from you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Muli inaanyayahan ho namin kayo sa Journeys of Hope ano, this weekend. This weekend tsaka next weekend ho, pag-uusapan natin yung prayer. Kasi nga, di ba, panibagong season, season of Advent. So this weekend we'll begin to talk about prayer that hopefully will help us during this Advent season and also to prepare for Christmas. Now we'll also reflect on the four Sundays of Advent together with prayer. And then next weekend we will talk about contemplative prayer, centering prayer. So we have 2 weekends of prayer. Hopefully it's going to be very helpful for the coming Advent season. Maraming salamat po and have a good day ahead and have a good weekend ahead. Salamat po.
Purihin ang Diyos at magpasalamat tayo sa Kanya. Ipapatupad na po natin ang ating Ale Kapwa Legacy Program ng Caritas Pilipinas, Pamilya Feeding Program at Educational Assistance Program para sa ating mga kabataan. 6 na mga dioceses ang tatanggap ng tulong para sa Pamilya Feeding Program. Ang dioceses ng Kidapawan, Cotabato, Capiz, Dumaguete, Infanta at Libmanan. Bawat pamilya po ay bibigyan natin ng 300 pesos every day. At ang bawat diocese ay pipiliin natin ang mga beneficiaries, 60 families for every diocese. At itong tulong ay ibibigay natin for 6 months. Para naman sa ating Educational Assistance Program, 10 mga dioceses ang bibigyan natin ng tulong. Ang dioceses ng Bontoc, Basilan, Hulo, Marawi, Libmanan, Infanta, Dumaguete, Capiz, Cotabato at Kidapawan. Bawat diocese po ay pipili ng 50 na mga kabataan. At ang bawat bata na ating tutulungan ay bibigyan natin ng 10,000 pesos. At maliban dyan, ay tutulungan pa natin na magkaroon sila ng mga gadgets para sa kanilang pag-aaral. Ang lahat po nito ay ating ginagawa upang ang ating mga kababayan ay maiangat natin sa kanilang paghihirap at mabigyan natin ng magandang kinabukasan ang ating mga kabataan. Tulungan niyo po ang Caritas Pilipinas. Magtulungan po tayo para sa ating bayan. Kapwa ko, pananagutan ko.